All right, Jen.
We're all cleared.
We're cleared to go. We're going on the Disney magic. You ready?
Yeah, let's go. I'm all hungry. Right. Cabanas.
All right, we're ready. We're ready. We're ready. We're ready.
Get it on the next one. Y'all have fun.
Now. Thank you. You ready, Jen?
Yes, I'm so ready.
Good morning from Port of Miami.
Oh, yeah.
Where we're about to embark on a 5-night Marvel Day at Sea cruise on the Disney Magic.
Yeah.
Now, which is your grand slam.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now, we're not in front of the Disney Magic because we parked really far away.
Yeah, they made us park all the way down at a parking garage at the very, very front of the port, and then they bus us over there.
Yeah.
So, interesting experience.
So this is not the intro we really expected.
Correct. Or not the one we're used to from Port Canaveral.
Yeah.
But super excited. We have a first day. It's a double dip at Castaway Key. So, the first day, we leave Miami, we go to Castaway Key, then we have Marvel Day at Sea, then we go back to Castaway Key, and then the fourth day we stop at
Nassau,
Bahamas, which I think we're probably going to stay on the ship just to explore the amenities on the ship and what it has to offer, and then we come back here to Miami. So if you guys are ready for a 5-night Marvel Day at Sea
extravaganza,
let's go. All right, Jen.
We're all cleared.
We're cleared to go. We're going on the Disney magic. You ready?
Yeah, let's go. I'm all hungry. Right. Cabanas.
All right, we're ready. We're ready. We're ready. We're ready.
Get it on the next one now. Y'all have fun. Now.
Thank you.
You ready, Jen?
Yes, I'm so ready.
So here's the vessel that we will be embarking on today. Jen's Grand Slam.
Woo!
The Disney magic. Is that you hitting a Grand Slam?
Yes. Get me on the ship.
Here we go on the Disney Magic, the first Disney ship.
And my Grand Slam.
And your Grand Slam. All right, so we're just gonna get our QR code scanned and we'll be on the ship. You ready, Jen?
Yeah. Tammy, Jennifer, and Brendan.
Yes, all good? All right. Going on the Disney Magic on this long terminal.
Yes.
You excited?
Yes.
I see you got your Captain Marvel bag because you are ready for this Marvel Day at Sea.
Yeah.
Now Mickey insisted on joining me here to be the first to welcome you before the beautiful Disney Magic. We've missed you. And we can't tell you how great it is to see our stunning Asian filled with families again. Families prefer to make lifelong memories together. Now our family onboard has been working tirelessly to ensure that every detail is taken care of. So you can experience the magic that is Disney. So Captain Mickey, take it away!
Look at Mickey go! Look at him go!
Check out the statue in the atrium. Mickey Mouse. Sailor Mickey. Oh, look. Marvel Day at Sea. How fun, Jen.
It's like laid out so differently.
Yeah, it is.
It's cold out here. It's January. I'm already here. Confirm. Scan sign.
Interesting. It makes you scan the sign? To verify that you, in fact, did show up.
And then you have to play the video. Seven minutes.
However, your participation is very important, and we need your help Brandon's washing his hands because we're going to Cabana's. Wash them good.
Wash your hands.
Real good. It's Nemo themed here at the Magic, which is really cute. It's not so much buffet style. They serve you here, which is just fine. So they bring you over to the section that they want you to pick from, and you can sit anywhere. It's just for distancing.
So Jen, what did we get from Cabana's?
I got the seafood gumbo, mac and cheese, and some salmon with pea sauce or something like that.
Interesting.
Yeah, what'd you get?
I got french fries, chicken, and bread, and butter. The Brandon special.
This might be too hot for me, we'll see. No.
No? Mm-mm. Good?
And it's not too hot, because it's kind of hot in here. But it's not too hot, so that's good. I'm gonna try some good old-fashioned mac and cheese. Can't go wrong. And some salmon. I like it. Very good.
It's a winner.
Mm-hmm. There's Miami.
Miami.
Welcome to Miami.
So we are in our stateroom and it is an ocean view with Verandah, where we're going to give you a quick tour of our ocean view with Verandah stateroom on the Disney Magic. So right when you first walk into the room, we have our closet, which is pretty spacious. You can store all your Tommy Bahama shirts or Spirit jerseys. And then over here is the other side of the closet. It's got a safe, a place to put your shoes or flip-flops. And then over here we have our Castaway Club gift this go-around, which is the sling bag. And you've got some drawers down here. Picture of Mr. and Miss Walt Disney on deck in 1934. Not this deck, but a deck of another ship. And then we've got Jen off in the distance. Hello, Jen.
Hi, I'm tired from our long drive.
Yes, it was a long drive.
Orlando.
And look, Sebastian has made it once again. You got the bed, very comfy bed, very plush. Got some more cabinets here. Conjoining room. Picture of Pirates of the Caribbean. Artist Mark Davis. And then we've got our TV, which we've pulled out and kind of angled. We were watching a little bit of Guardians of the Galaxy.
And then it went berserk and put on soccer.
Yeah, it started putting on soccer. Kind of had
and
a life of its own.
Now it won't do anything.
Well,
so I
think they're about to do the muster drill.
What's on there? Oh, it's the Incredibles.
Oh, you see the Incredibles on there? Yeah, you see characters every now and then just pop up.
Yeah.
Anyway, bed, couch, which is a pull-out bed. Then you've got the fridge down here. You got a hair dryer.
They have an old one in the bathroom too.
Yeah. And then you have an empty drawer. And it's a little bit different of a design than the Dream and Fantasy. A little bit more open, actually. There's less shelves. I think the Dream and the Fantasy had shelves up there, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, yeah.
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 And then nice little table. This used, I think the ottomans, they used to have the ottomans.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the trunk ottoman. I don't see an ottoman here.
I don't know.
A little bit different.
I don't remember.
And then a pen and a door hanger. And then the view of our veranda and Miami. A pretty cool view. And we're on deck 6. Checking out. Look at that. Get the plane taken off. Miami Airport's right that direction over here. Wow. It's pretty cool. And we're going to end up going out that way. Out to Castaway Key. And then coming back to the entrance over here, you have the bathroom. Which this is the tub and shower. So if you come in here, you'll see, here's the tub and shower, complete with the H2O product line. And then you've got the clothesline. You got the sink. It's pretty good. And I've noticed that the tiles are textured. Like my socks are gripping to it, so that's a good thing. In the next room is the toilet. So you'll see you got the toilet. Then you have these shelves. Very good lighting in here. Much better than the other one. And then you have a very old hair dryer built into the wall. And then another sink, so you and somebody else can be getting ready at the same time. So it's pretty cool. Plenty of HTO products too.
Look at that Miami traffic. Oof. We hit some of that coming here. But there's Miami, part of Miami. So, and then over here, super expensive homes. So there's that too. The Carnival Conquest is sure jamming. I don't know if you can hear that music, but it's really loud. So I think they're heading out to sea, probably. But they are jamming. Now you can get a feel for how loud they are. They're like, hey, we're here. Have fun, Carnival Conquest. I guess it's a live band, I'm not sure, but everybody's waving, not paying attention to the band.
All right, off we go.
Vacation, out. All everyone said.
Check
vacation.
It out, they got the Coast Guard. Got the Coast Guard running right alongside us as we leave Port Miami.
Woo!
Right over there is Star Island, where all the major celebrities live.
I thought it was that one.
No, that's one of the islands.
But one point of the star?
That is Star Island.
Wow.
Look at some of the boats out there.
That one had a big yacht, too.
Did it?
Yeah.
We're about to come up to a big yacht right around the corner.
That's a houseboat. That's definitely a houseboat. Wow.
That's a houseboat, and that's Star Island right there. That's where all the superstars live. I think, what is it, Shaquille O'Neal lived there, Rosie O'Donnell, a bunch of other people.
Can I go over there? Like, can we drive over
there? I don't think so, no.
But look, there's no gate.
I think there's a gate, like, closer inside, yeah.
Okay. I just want to pretend to be rich.
Life of the rich and famous.
You get lost in those houses.
Check it out. You got a car ferry.
That's like the Cape May Ferry, you can take it tomorrow.
Wow. And yeah, that's a man-made island.
I see the gate.
It's a man-made island with superstar houses.
It's got a gate.
Yeah, no. Not allowed on Star Island, Jen.
No. I mean, I'm not a star, so it's
fine. I don't know. You're a star in my eyes.
Oh.
There goes the car ferry. See you later. Taking the cars, I don't know where they go.
It's called a flamingo.
Oh yeah, you're right, they are sitting. Oh, that's weird.
Look, there's one coming in.
Oh my goodness, we're getting all sorts of cool views.
It's better than sitting in Miami traffic.
That is so weird. I wonder what this ferry does.
It's better than sitting in Miami traffic.
That is so funny. Yeah, they're just sitting in there. And a lot of them look like they're like in their business suits, so is that...
That's where they... Look, there's a golf cart.
There's a golf cart right there. That's funny. Wow, I wonder where that goes. That yacht right there says Usher.
Hi, Usher's boat.
I don't think it's Usher's boat.
He'd have a bigger boat.
Yeah, he'd have a boat that looks like that.
Yeah.
Now that's a
yacht. He's waving. Hello.
Oh yeah, he is.
Hello.
Hello down there.
He stopped.
Oh, he stopped waving at me.
They all just hang out on their boats. Oh, he's taking a picture of the ship.
Yeah. It's like Inception with cameras. Hello. I'm recording you and you're recording me.
You must not be from around these parts.
And then you got this giant yacht. Holy cow, that's huge. The Aquarius.
With one guy on it.
With one guy at the top, yep. He's just chilling at the top. Is he gonna wave?
Nah.
Hey, he did wave. Hello.
He's too cool for us.
Well, I mean, he's on a giant yacht, so.
There's always just one person on each boat. It's so funny. Yep. There's one on just Jay's.
Wow, look at this. These condos on the water here. Wow. Can you imagine living in one of these, like, sky rises, like these condos?
I need to know how much it is. And then they've got a lot of, like, greenery.
Yeah, a lot of greenery on the roof.
How much does that go for?
Even on this one up here.
This one's got more.
Yeah.
I like the color of the coral one, though.
The coral one?
Yeah.
Are you shopping for condos in Miami?
The traffic was horrid, so no. That was
Look
a
at
lot.
All these people at this park here.
Oh, that's so fun. Oh, look how cool that is.
That's
Hello.
A cool park. Hello. Hello, everybody.
We're going on a cruise, you're not. we'll bring you back nothing.
We'll bring you back nothing. We'll bring you back memories on YouTube.
I'll tell you all about it when I get back. There's like no barrier between the water, and that's kind of a cool park, though.
Yeah. Check out that seaplane, Jen. What? Right over Miami Beach.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
Wow.
Oh, that might be a wedding.
All right, we're coming up to Miami Beach over here.
That Smith and Wolinski's.
Are you talking about the restaurant?
Yeah, it looks popular.
Hey, the Coast Guard's waving to us. See you later.
Bye,
thank you.
Thank
Watch
you.
That wave. All right, he escorted us out, Jen. It's open seas from here.
I can't believe we made it.
I know. 2.5 years.
Bye. Bye. We did it.
Waving to all the people along the cove.
They're all in clusters. Maybe they're cults. Don't you see that, though? Nobody, wait, cluster.
All right, so this is Miami Beach over here, Jen.
Oh, I think it's Miami Beach. They've got a reflector.
Yeah, they got Miami Beach right over there.
Oh, is that
a
it?
Big giant tanker off in the horizon.
Oh, he's coming back.
Oh, he's coming back.
You're not safe yet. You're not safe yet. He's like, hold on.
He's escorting it. Oh, it's because
that
boat right there is trying to come in. See, that's the thing, is they escort us out. Whenever a boat tries to come in as we're going out, it's a hazard. That's why we were doing the horn, is to get this guy out of here.
Oh, I thought it was fun.
Yeah, he's in the way. Hey, check it out. Miami Beach. The famous Miami Beach.
I'd rather have
a There's famous Miami Beach. It's a little too cold to be at the beach, though.
I don't know how these people are voluntarily standing out there. I don't know, I'm cold.
And this is the guy. He's probably gonna get in trouble with the Coast Guard right now.
Ticket him. Pull him up. How do you pull over a boat?
I don't know, but he's about to get in trouble for...
How do you pull over a boat?
Getting too close to us.
They're waving. Oh my god, that Coast Guard is so cool. He's got short sleeves.
There he goes. We're free, Jen.
So
we're
my
free.
Hair.
So kind of interesting. You see those orange buoys out there?
Yeah.
That's our guide. It's kind of like our runway.
Can it take us right to Castaway Key?
It can. It takes us right out to the Atlantic. And there's Miami. Say, see you later, Miami. We'll see you in 5 days. All right. Off to Castaway Key.
Yeah, I'm gonna go inside. I'm cold.
Okay. So now that we are at sea, I think what we're going to do now is we're going to go down to the stores because you saw something.
The magic spirit jersey.
You got to add it to your collection.
It will be mine.
You've already like staked your claim. You walk by the window and you're like, I'm getting that.
It's 5:50. We got to go.
It opens at 6. So we're going to head downstairs so that you can get your spirit jersey.
Gotta get I bet no one else is going to be waiting except me, but it's
probably
fine.
So we'll also check out some of the merch too.
Yeah.
Since you guys love Disney Cruise Line merch.
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
So we're in the store and I found the magic pin. It's yellow. We're gonna buy it, so we'll insert the price because I'm not sure. We're also going to get this. It's the magic. We get them for all of them, so this is my last one. I have all of them for $49.99. You don't have stickers. They have them for you.
They're window clings, I think.
Window clings?
Yeah.
Oh.
So you put them on your car.
Oh, so you can't even use them for your door.
Well, you could put them on your balcony window.
Oh, I guess so. $19.99. And then these are magnets. These are really cool. I think we have the fantasy, right, or something?
Yeah.
Purple. We're not buying this, so I don't know how much it is. But it's purple. Then you have this kid's shirt here. Disney Magic with Goofster for $24.99. Oh, yeah, spoiler alert, we already bought stuff. I will show you what we bought. So I bought this $74.99 front, back, bought it, mine. This is a magic frame, 5x7 for $29.99. Look how cute, and we might buy that too. We haven't bought that yet. It's on the maybe list. Here's the adult shirt, Disney Magic.
Some more magic branded.
$34.99. Nothing on the back.
It says sport tech on it. I wonder
but
if
it doesn't
like,
feel very sporty.
Yeah, it's kind of thick actually.
Yeah.
Huh.
Dooney. It's got all your pals on there. Cruise line. How much are you? $108. We are not purchasing this. Then you got this. How stinking cute is that? Look at him.
Perfect for Valentine's Day.
Right?
It's in the shape of a heart.
$39.95.
See, the base is in the shape of a heart.
It is. Love it.
And I really like this shirt, the Captain Mickey, and it's $24.99. Yeah, $24.99. It says Disney Cruise Line on it. I like that a lot.
Okay, this is the Dooney. That is so cute. It's got towel animals on it. It's my favorite part, but mini golf, Mickey pool, Donald's and spa, hot tub. Oh my God. Oh, Goof singing karaoke.
Oh yeah, you're right.
How cute. How stinky. Minnie's got drink of the day. Oh, love it. Got this Cruise Line spirit jersey here. I don't know if we've seen this. Disney Cruise Line. You know, typical. It doesn't have the price, but I'm assuming it's $74.99, which is the OG price.
What's it at now? $79?
Like $84.
What?
They went up. They skyrocketed.
Oh, man.
It's really sad. Helly Hansen has, you know, it's pretty cold out there, so... $175, but that's kind of cool.
Yeah.
And it looks really nice.
Well, the Helly Hansen's the brand that you see in Norway. In the Norway
Pavilion. But it's thin under here, though.
Is it? It's kind of like a windbreaker.
Oh, okay. Oh, it's we are Ooh. Windy out there, yeah. I brought those. So they had this at Disney, the same thing.
But it didn't say Cruise Line, though.
No, but it was Walt Disney World.
Yeah.
They don't even have my size, so I can't get it, so that's fine. I think it's $74.99. I'm assuming so.
Yeah, it's got the rose gold pattern at the bottom.
Yeah. And then you got the leggings here too.
Anchors.
To match.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Interesting.
These are $34.99.
Okay. Well, it's jumping out at you.
I don't need leggings. $430. I mean, it is Tommy Bahama, so that's expected. But... Captain Mickey.
Yeah, Captain Mickey in all these different poses.
Walking, he's got his anchor. He's posing.
It's cute.
Then we have this Life's Better at Sea by Disney Cruise Line. It's $32.99. I like it, it's cute. I've never seen it before, at least. So you got these three polos.
It's got a weird pattern on it.
Yeah, they're all $70. This reminds me of an orange. But I love oranges. And then you got
that
stripes.
Reminds you of a blueberry?
It reminds me of a sailor.
Okay, all right.
And then you've got this one, which I'm not going to say it.
Pinstripes? Jailbird?
Jailbird.
So they say this is a new arrival, but I feel like I've seen this one before.
Maybe
in the
was
parks.
It at the Tommy Bahama store?
Possibly.
I don't
but
see
I feel like
place.
I've seen this one at the parks. I remember specifically seeing the ships, and I think I remember seeing the red flowers. But anyway, this is a new, according to Disney Cruise Line, but I don't know the price.
Oh, $130.
$130. I should have known.
Yeah.
So there you go, $130 for this. Oh, look at Donald.
He's jumping.
And you can't escape Walt Disney World's 50th celebration, even on a cruise.
This is that luxe one that's like real expensive.
It's like that corduroy.
It's not even soft.
Really? It's kind of thin.
Yeah, it's all right.
Hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
So if you are missing out on the luxe collection, you can get it on the Disney Magic.
And this is not new. I mean, the logo's new. So I have the old logo.
Oh, yeah.
I have the old logo.
It's pretty cool.
And then this is the new logo. I like mine better.
Yeah, because it's got the ship.
Yeah.
Like, that's a little...
$60, $59.99.
Yep, so I like the one you have.
Me too.
It's cool.
Yeah.
And it's got the same little gold medallion.
My medallion's there.
It's hidden underneath your
leg. Oh yeah, it's a little bit bigger.
So now we're gonna go into Mickey's Mainsail where they've got some Marvel Day at Sea.
And 2022 merch.
So right when you first walk in, they've got Marvel Day at Sea Turvis, which you'll see here has got all the Marvel, main Marvel characters. And then you've got a price of $39.99. It says Disney Cruise Line. However, I don't think this is dishwasher safe. Almost positive. Still a cool mug though. And they even have the Marvel Day at Sea pin. It's a limited edition pin for $17.99.
We might have to buy one of those.
Yeah, that's cool. Just to, you know, commemorate Marvel Day at Sea. So here is the Marvel Day at Sea shirt for $34.99. It says Marvel Day at Sea on the collar, and it's got the white stripe on the top. I don't know. I figured it would have more color to it.
Me too. Did you say the price?
$34.99. But it does have Iron Man on it. But I think we'll end up getting this pin, because this one actually has a lot of the Avengers on it. It's kind of cool. Limited edition Marvel Day at Sea.
$17.99.
All right. And they have all sorts of ornaments on this back wall here. I love this one a lot. He's so funny in his arms.
He's $22.99.
Hand painted. And then we gotta get one of these to put on our tree. We always get the ship on our tree.
Always.
It's pretty cool. And they even have some 2021 that hasn't been reduced yet. I'm kind of surprised. But they do have 2022, which reminds me, we need to go check out the 2022 section.
Oh, yeah.
Because they have some more merch over there. So they do have 2022 Turvis stainless steel tumblers for $39.99.
It's kind of cool.
Yeah, it's kind of neat. I don't think it's dishwasher safe, though.
No.
But you're seeing this pattern of Mickey kind of appear everywhere, even on this shirt, this women's shirt.
$39.99.
Oh, and look, Happy New Year. We were not on the cruise during the Happy New Year, though. That would have been cool.
It's $19.99.
And then we even have this pin, which is the 2022 Mickey, Captain Mickey. It's kind of fun.
We purchased it.
Yeah, we did. It's priced at yellow. So make sure you have enough yellow in your bank account. We got plenty of Captain Minnie in the house.
And Captain Mickey.
And a really cool Raglan shirt for $34.99. It's Captain Mickey on it.
He's cute.
It's kind of neat. It's like a three-quarter sleeve.
Yeah.
Perfect for those nights on your veranda.
I need more than that on the veranda.
Oh, is it that cold for you?
I'm cold.
Good thing you got a spirit jersey.
Yes. $44.99.
And it looks like they just have large, extra large, and XXL.
I do wish they had my size.
Yeah.
I do like that
one. Cool. Soft, too.
Yeah.
And you got a really cute kids shirt with Captain Mickey on it.
$21.99.
Pretty cool. It's
like a burgundy. I wish this was in adults.
I know, because that's a cool color.
I do like the color, yeah.
All right, so we're back in the stateroom after a quick shopping spree. Jen, do you want to go over some of the stuff that we've got?
Yeah.
That we laid it out right here on the bed.
So I got my Magic Spirit jersey. He's so cute. And then we got 2022 pin, Magic pin, the ship, we don't want to undo it because I don't, you know, got to keep it safe. And then Mickey for you.
Yeah, cool shirt. Yeah. So we got a nice little shopping spree.
Yeah.
Didn't go overboard.
No.
A lot of the merch is the same merch that we kind of covered at Disney Springs, and we'll put a link in the description box down below to that video.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of cool, unique merchandise that we've only seen here on the ship.
Well, once I got this, I said I'm good. I don't have to buy anything else. So.
You're set now.
I'm happy.
Add that to your spirit jersey collection. Okay, so now it is time for our dinner reservation.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to go downstairs. Tonight we have Lumiere's.
Yeah.
We're going to have some dinner at Lumiere's. I've never been. You've never been. Did you go to Lumiere's on the Wonder?
I don't remember what it was.
Okay.
So maybe it was Lumiere's. I can't remember.
Might have been Lumiere's. But this is the first time we've had Lumiere's on the Magic. We already looked at the menu because they have it on the app.
Yeah.
There's some pretty good stuff. So if you're ready for some good dinner.
Let us go.
Let's go. All right. We're going to go in Lumiere's, which is themed, which is a dining room themed to Beauty and the Beast. All right. We are back at our room. I don't know if we showed you this magnet that we got, but it says the tourist trek. It says Marvel Day at Sea and the dates. And it even tells you the itinerary. Pretty cool. Anyway, let's see what towel animal we have.
Oh my gosh, it's a turtle.
Oh.
And then it's got, these are different chocolates. It says Sweet Dreams.
Ooh, yeah, you're right. Sweet Dreams. Does it say Disney Cruise Line on it? Those are different.
It has a ship.
Okay, so it's probably Disney branded.
Yeah, oh my god,
it's
how
a turtle. That's one we've never seen before.
No,
that's
I love
cute. It. Aww, he's our friend.
I love him.
And took care of your Sebastian. Sebastian's looking out for our Ted the turtle.
Ted the turtle.
Ted the turtle.
Done.
All right, so we're going to get changed. Yeah, we don't need that in here. We're going to get changed, and then we're going to go to
Fathoms,
because what's the thing that's going on tonight?
Intuition.
Now, I don't know what intuition is.
It says something about use your intuition. This hilarious adult game show is based upon your ability to use your intuition.
Okay. I wonder, well, we'll figure it out.
I don't have to play anything. I'm just going to watch.
Yeah, we're going
to
watch.
That's what I like to do.
We're
going to
watch. Maybe it's gonna be funny.
I'm the wallflower. I just watched.
You're the Anyway, let's get changed, and then we'll go down to Fathoms, and then we're gonna enjoy the adult entertainment tonight.
Yeah.
We were looking at this painting on the way down, and it's from Walt Disney's film How to Dance in 1953. Jen, do you think that's Cinderella?
It looks like her, but
that's
I don't
with
think
Goof?
It is. I don't think it is.
It's always fun looking at the artwork.
It looks like, not Princess Cinderella, but also Princess Cinderella all at the same time.
The backside of Cinderella.
Cleaning hair.
Yes.
It's her cleaning hair.
Yes.
But then the dress.
Interesting. You fully analyzed Cinderella and all her different outfits and wardrobes. Check out this one, Jen. This is kind of cool.
They don't have the moving paintings here, do they?
No, they don't have the moving paintings, but they have some really unique paintings I've never seen on any other ship. Like the Big Tipper and the triplets, Huey, Dewey, and Louie. The Green Comet.
I think I can really get this in my...
It's kind of fun.
Yeah.
All right, we are heading into After Hours, which is home to Fathoms. Keys, which is a piano bar, and O'Gill's pub. This is kind of the after hours area where adults go. There's no kids allowed. So change of plans, this is actually 80s music trivia in Fathoms. After 80s music trivia, then it goes to intuition. So
yeah,
we're gonna ride this out, and then
I'm not gonna know any of it.
You're not gonna... I like 80s music.
Well, I like it. I just don't know the names of songs and stuff.
Okay. All right. Fair enough.
American, yay! First person to do that. I mean, pointing to, when you see me pointing to, go ahead and give us your answer nice and quick. If it's correct, you get a point, and everybody goes like this.
Yay!
These are my people. Thank you so much. Good job. Good job. She said, did I do it right? That's fine. All right. So are you ready?
Sure.
Very good. Here's a question. George Foreman was famous for what sport? George Foreman famous for what sport?
Boxing.
Max Ramon, take out a point! Good job. I would have taken Hurley to see this. Everybody said it. Makes sense. Okay, ready? Do me a favor, finish this. Maybe she's born with it, maybe it's.
Maybelline.
He got it right! You don't want to know how you knew that, but that's fine. So. It's 2022. You can know whatever you want to know.
Husband's over there.
Very good. Here's the question. Tell me, what was the name of the group that Beyonce sang with?
Destiny's Child.
Yeah! I'm sure you knew it as well, Jay. Very good. Here's your question. What was the number on Jackie Robinson's uniform? The number on Jackie Robinson's uniform. Number on Jackie Robinson's uniform. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You want to try?
3.
Really?
I had to guess.
Audience, what is it?
42.
42. And there was even a movie called 42.
So that's going to wrap up day one on the Disney Magic.
Yeah.
It was fun.
Yes.
It was kind of surreal, the whole process.
Yeah.
We need to talk about the boarding process because we didn't really cover too much about that.
So we came in from Miami. We parked in a parking garage that was nowhere near the terminal. We had to take a shuttle over, which was really weird. Because when I came on the Wonder years ago, I swear we parked right across. There was no shuttle. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know what happened there. So we got shuttled over, and then, you actually, like, go in to do your test, which was interesting.
Yeah, you go into the terminal, go through security, and then once you're in security, then we had to do our test. When we did our test, they kind of put you in a nice little alcove, alcove. They tell you to do 5 swabs in one nostril and then 5 swabs in the next. And then they ask you to write your name on the label for the test tube.
And your birthday.
And they tell you to go wait in a room, which had to be the 20 longest minutes of your life.
But it said it was going to be an hour. They said it was going to be an hour. So we were like, okay. But I like kept refreshing because I was like, well, I'm impatient. So...
And then, like, 20 minutes later, it said that you're free to board?
Yeah, so, like, when I refreshed it, I didn't think it was going to show up. And I was like, I literally whispered it. I said, we're clear to board. And he's like, what? Because I just couldn't believe it. Well, I could believe it. We're fine. But, like, it's so stressful.
I know. Like, yeah, and you don't want something like that after a 3.5-hour drive to be the reason why you can't get on. But then we did the boarding process. Pretty exciting. Now, the entrance into the ship or the lobby was a little bit different than normal.
Yeah.
They still announce your name.
Wasn't as much clapping
because there's not as many people in the lobby. They made you stand in your circles, and then that's where you watched Captain Mickey,
welcome
do some really awesome dance moves.
Oh my god, he had some moves.
And then that was pretty much it. It was an interesting process, a little bit different, not as streamlined as the Port Canaveral boarding process, but that's come to be expected. Disney operates out of Port Canaveral almost daily, it seems. They're just more a well-oiled machine when it comes to that. And then we had dinner at Lumiere's. Mm-hmm. What do you think about Lumiere's?
It was the best part of the day.
It was really good. The food was really, really good.
Oh, let's talk about Mickey.
Yeah. Oh, yes, that's right. Mickey just suddenly shows up in the middle of dinner.
Minnie, Donald, Goofy, and Pluto.
Yeah, so the lights turned on, and we thought, oh, maybe it would be...
And this music started, and I was like, oh, it'll be Belle, because it's Lumiere.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But then it was the Fab Five, and I just cried.
It was like a dine-in, like a, what is it, the character dine-ins?
Yeah.
It's really fun. It was really cool.
That was my, like, Disney I'm here moment. I just cried.
You might have teared up.
I want to cry again just thinking about it. I videoed it, so if it's terrible, I was crying, so, you know.
Yeah. And then we got some dinner and made sure to take pictures of it. And for our appetizers, what did you get?
I got the farmhouse salad. It had some oil dressing, and then it had... goat cheese, which I've never had before. It was okay, but it was really good. It was my healthy option.
And then I got the potato leek soup, which I remember having on the Dream and Fantasy, and it was really good. It had a very buttery taste to it.
Yeah, it was good. I tried
super super good, and especially good. And you brought up a good suggestion: take the bread, the fresh baked bread, and the rolls, and dip it in that. So good.
Yeah,
highly recommend. And then. For the main course,
I got the salmon.
Mm-hmm.
And that was really good. And it had cauliflower. It looked like mashed potatoes, but it was cauliflower puree. That was the word.
Okay.
Cauliflower puree. And then some horseradish. And it was really, really good. Really good.
Yeah, you downed the entire plate.
Yeah. The only thing that threw me is it looked like mashed potatoes. So my mind kept saying... Oh, mashed potatoes, but then it wasn't. So I was just in my head.
I ended up getting the Chateaubriand roasted filet steak, which is a roasted filet steak, crushed new potatoes with shallots, buttered green beans, red wine juice, and beignets sauce on the side. It was actually really good. I ended up getting it medium well, which the waiter recommended doing medium rare, right? Is that what he said?
Medium, I forget. It was red.
Yeah, it was very red, though. It was, from what I was seeing, it was very red, so I ended up going with medium well because I don't like too much red. Very good flavor, and it wasn't dried out. The waiter did warn me that it could be dry. It was not. It had
plenty of flavor.
It was some of the best cut steak I think I've ever had. So, really good. Yeah. Dinner was a huge success. And then for dessert, what did you get?
I got the apple tart, and it wasn't my favorite. It was almost too much cinnamon, I think.
Really?
Like, yeah. So, I didn't finish. Well, there was a little ice cream on there. I finished that. But, yeah, it was okay. It wasn't my favorite.
And then I got the strawberry shortcake sundae, which was good. Can't go wrong with that.
Yeah.
So, overall, very fun day. Tomorrow, we have Castaway Key, and we've got some adventures planned for Castaway Key. It's going to be a fun day. So, if you like the video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. If you haven't yet, Jen, tell them what to do.
Make sure to tap that subscribe button and tap that notification bell to become a super subscriber.
Until next time, see you real soon. Good morning from Castaway Key. Hey, Mickey. I'm gonna go way up there.
Oh! Don't you dare! Why did I say yes to this?
Why did you say yes to this? I know, this is high. Oh. Wow. Holy cow. I think we might be coming back in.
I don't like it. Oh, are you serious?